Scientists may have just dropped one of the boldest findings in cancer research yet, and possibly one of the best ways to significantly lower your risk of developing certain types of cancer. For me, it's one of the studies I've been wishing to see for a long time. So let's get into it. Researchers tracked 79,468 adults from both the US and Canada for nearly 8 years, none of whom had cancer at the start of the study. All of them were part of the Adventist Health Study too. And what the study did was compared different dietary profiles: vegans, lacto-ovo-vegetarians, who eat dairy and eggs, pesco-vegetarians, who eat fish, and non-vegetarians, and matched participants' data with cancer registry records. Many in the online health space have described the results as having jaw-dropping numbers. So here's what the researchers found. When they compared these groups with participants who ate meat at least weekly, they found that vegetarians overall had about a 12% lower risk of developing any cancer, and an 18% lower risk for a group of medium-frequency cancers, such as thyroid, melanoma, pancreatic, and ovarian. There were three cancers, though, that saw significant reductions, and they were colorectal cancer, 21% lower, stomach cancer, 45% lower, and lymphoproliferative cancers such as lymphoma were 25% lower. Out of all three vegetarian categories, vegans had the lowest chance of developing cancer overall at 24%, and younger vegans had a particularly lower chance of developing prostate cancer with a 43% risk reduction, and breast cancer with a 31% reduction. The vegans also had a 23% decreased risk of medium-frequency cancers. Now, whilst this is incredibly exciting, we have to consider it wasn't a perfect study. This is because it was an observational study, which means it can't prove cause and effect. However, the authors did say that the associations were strong and persuasive. And this next drawback is interesting, as the participants already followed healthier than average lifestyles, meaning non-vegetarian Adventists still ate less meat and drank less alcohol than the general population. So the actual cancer protective impact of vegetarian diets might be even stronger. The reason I feel this is so significant, especially right now, is the amount of the benefits of the carnivore diet comments popping up on my videos recently seems to have risen dramatically. And also in the media, which is really concerning. In this next video, Dr. Brooke Goldner explains why some people see these benefits on a carnivore diet. To view that video, you can click the middle of the screen, but the video will also be pinned at the top of the comments below.